Hey there, it's Calvin Strawn, creator of the Find a Way to Win program, teaching you how to discover how to perform your best under pressure. Well, I got a bit of a share for you. This past summer, I had a kidney stone. And it was excruciating. And it's an important part of my story that ties to performing your best under pressure. But before I get to the kidney stone, I want to talk to you about your heart rate. So if you were to feel your pulse and look at a second on a clock, your a good heart rate's about 60 beats per minute, 70 beats per minute. If you're in decent shape, you're around 60, 70, maybe 80 beats a minute for a normal-ish heart rate, let's say. Does that make sense? So let's get back to my story about my kidney stone. So I'm in my house, in my basement, and I have this kidney stone. I've never had it before. If you've never had one, hopefully never do, because it's an excruciating amount of pain. So I was in my basement, totally doubled over in pain, trying to be macho, trying to suck it up, I can take it, right? But I was dying, couldn't breathe, couldn't talk, couldn't function. My wife comes downstairs and she sees me here as a puddle of mess on the floor and says, oh my God, you have to go to the hospital. Now being tough as I am, I said, no. Not going to the hospital. So I had my thoughts with me a little bit, but I was in a lot of pain. And the reason I didn't want to go to the hospital is because, God, there's no way I could sit in line like this. Like, I couldn't sit in a chair. I was just, no, I can't. It'll be fine. I can get through it. And then it got to a little while later, maybe an hour later, I was like, okay, I was sweating. I couldn't breathe properly. I'm doubled over. I'm wincing. I'm grunting. And I'm scaring my kids. Right? And so finally I said, listen, call an ambulance, because at least the ambulance will get me ahead of the line at the hospital. Now, if you've never called an ambulance before, or the paramedics, it's quite embarrassing as well. And so what happens is the fire truck shows up and there's sirens, and then the ambulance shows up and there's sirens, and your neighbors are coming out and looking what's going on. I'm thinking, oh my God, this is so embarrassing. I can do it, right? So in comes the fireman. He comes into my home. He sees me there writhing on the floor like a crazy person. And he says, listen, Cal, we're gonna take your heart rate and your vitals and your blood pressure, okay? And I said, whatever, because I'm dying. And sure enough, he takes my heart rate and he takes my blood pressure. And he goes, listen, your heart rate is 80 beats per minute. And I said, what? 80 beats per minute is a normal heart rate. That means nothing's happening. All right, and then he says, your blood pressure is about 120 over 80, which again is normal. I feel like I'm gonna die. And so I couldn't believe it. I was literally fabricating. I actually, in the middle of the pain, I was like, are you kidding me? And he's like, no, this is it. And I was like, holy shit. And so he gave me some Toradol, but put me on a stretcher, out we went. Right, to deal with the kidney stone. But my point of my story is, I was actually fine. My mind magnified the huge thing of this story. Yes, truth, I was in pain. It was a serious situation. Don't underestimate that. But my mind magnified it. And now magnification is a distortion you'd find, or a label for a distortion, from cognitive behavioral therapy. Quite often, when you're under pressure, and you're feeling the strain of a situation, you will magnify it and make it much worse than it actually is. And when you do that, your mind's racing so fast, so quick, you can't think of the right solutions, you can't perform properly. So what I'm trying to get across here is, using my funny little kidney stone story, is be careful that you're not magnifying your current situation. And I see it all the time. When I'm speaking and training folks, maybe they got to do a presentation in front of their board or their committee or the investors or whoever it is, or they got to close a sale. And it's an important sale for their year or their quota, or potentially is, you know, having to go for an interview for a new position, or have to lead a team and have a difficult conversation. Any of these situations can get your mind racing and make you magnify it much more than it really is. So the key to overcome this and be better under pressure is, the cognitive behavioral therapists tell you, think of a rational thought to counter the magnification. Think of a rational thought that will counter that magnification. What really makes sense that will reduce your belief in that magnification? Does that make sense? So we're only got a few minutes here, but whatever you're going through, think of it. What's a rational thought that's gonna overcome this magnification so you get yourself back in the game? Does that make sense? Great. So tell you what, if you can do that, you will absolutely find a way to win. I'll see you on the next one. Hey there, thanks for stopping by and thanks for watching. Listen, if this video really resonated with you, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you get the latest updates on how to find a way to win and really perform well under pressure. And for an even deeper dive on the training, go by my website, calvinstrong.com. I promise your time will not be wasted. All the best, until next time.